Pleasant morning to all of you, all my dear children. Am I audible to you all? Yes, no. Okay. Is my voice clear, dear children? Is my voice clear? Right. Very good morning. Okay. Fine, dear children. Let me share you the book. Okay, so we have completed the lesson, right? Is there any doubt with the lesson, ma? I can't climb trees anymore. Is there any doubts? Okay, Ram Harish doesn't have any doubt. Niranjana also, very good. Others. Okay, fine. Very good, my dear children. So quickly, let us just go through the glossary part which is given here. See, look here. Turnstile. What is a turnstile? A mechanical gate consisting of revolving horizontal arms fixed to a vertical post, allowing only a person at a time to enter through. So I told you, I showed you what is a turnstile, right? This is the technical meaning of it. You will need to put everything in your mind just to make you aware that through this gate only one person can move in. So it's a rotating gate. That's the meaning of it. Hollyhocks. What is hollyhock? It is a tall Eurasian plant. Why they call it as Eurasian plant? Because it is grown in Europe as well as Asia. Okay, Eurasian plant of the mallow family. It comes under the mallow family with large showy flowers. They have beautiful flowers and they can grow tall enough also. Colonel. Who's a colonel? A rank of officer in the army. So in army, they have officers, no? Colonel, brigadier, havildar, so plenty of them. So brigadier is a rank of officer in the British army. Colonel is also in Indian army, but brigadier is only the term which is used in British army. Okay. And it is above the rank of colonel. Trapeze. What is trapeze? I have shown you the image of trapeze. It is a horizontal bar hanging by two ropes and free to swing. So you can swing on it. So in circus, you would have seen that. Used by acrobats in the circus. So this is what which is used there. Muttered. What is the meaning of muttered? Muttered is to utter words in a low tone. So talking in a very low tone, speaking very softly. Slithered. What is slithered? What is the meaning of slithered? Slide or slip. Okay, slip and fall down, no? So that is slithered. Pruning. Pruning means what? The act of trimming the plant. So trimming the plant is known as pruning. Bougainvillea. Bougainvillea is an ornamental shrubby climbing plant. So it's also a plant which is like a creeper. Okay. It is widely cultivated in the tropical countries. Chiming. What is the meaning of chiming? Making melodious ringing sound. Okay, making melodious ringing sound is known as chiming. Budgerigars. What is budgerigars? A small Australian bird of the parrot family, often kept in a cage as a pet. Cranking. What is cranking? Cranking is the sound, the act of turning a handle to start the engine. When you put the keys into the car and when you turn it on, so there will be a sound. So that is the cranking sound. Don't scribble, my dear children. I have already told you all not to scribble. Don't touch the screen at all. Sprightliness. What is sprightliness? Lively and full of energy. Being very energetic is known as sprightliness. Is there any doubt in the glossary part, my dear children? Any doubts with the glossary? Glossaries, you will have to definitely learn it. Okay, no doubt, sir. Say Srinija. Very good. What about the others, ma'am? Others? No. Fine, Rahini. All right, let's move on to the book bag exercises. A part. A part is based on the understanding of the story. Indicate either true or false. So I don't want you all to give true. Question number one, true. Question number two, true. I don't want to write like that. I want you all to put in your answers altogether and send it as a single answer in your chat column, right? Wrote up quickly, ma'am. Absolutely 100% you'll have to learn the glossary part for the examination. Not only for the examination, even for your public examination, glossary plays a very vital part. That's why we are discussing that. So altogether, 1 to 10, I need the answers. Okay, put it in a cluster. Don't write one by one and send it to me. I'll give you 3 minutes time. Just go through it. Read the question. Type it as true or false. Totally send it in total to me. Not like this, Ram Harish. I want you to do it on the whole. Altogether. All the clips. Make it fast. Very good, very good, dear children. Plenty of you all have streamed in with the answers in no time. Last one, little doubt. Okay, leave the last one alone, I'll enjoy. You can type the other one and send. No issues. Rahini, very good. Rahini. Yadu. So plenty have completed. Very good. So Rahini was the first justice. Three. Yadu was the second. Rahini, 3 times you have done it, right? Yadu, 2 times. Yadu, 4 times. Rajarishika, very good. Send it only once, my dear children. Don't send it all together. Shall we discuss the answers, ma? Shall we? Shan't we? Srinija has given the answer. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Okay. Let's discuss the answers. I know it's going to take a lot of time because it's very hard to type looking into the screen and then typing. The ones who are having the book, it's not going to be a big issue. You can write it there itself. The ones who are having the book can write it directly. The ones who are waiting for your books, you can just check the answers, write it in some other notebook, and then we can do it. The screen is so small. I think you can zoom in by yourself, right? Okay. Let's discuss the answers, kids. The visitor had hidden. You'll need and type the answer, my dear children. No more, no more typing. In cluster, you can put it. So when I teach you, if you are in another work, typing it busily, definitely you're going to miss the answers. So check the answers first. Okay, no issues. Don't worry at all. There is nothing. Everybody deserves my compliment. I know you all are very brilliant. So please don't type when I'm telling the answer. Right? See, the visitor had hidden a few coins in the tree. True. He has hidden some gold coins, right? So that is true. The first statement is true. The jackfruit tree was still there. Yes, absolutely. After 25 years, when the narrator went there, when he looked into the house, when he saw the jackfruit, he was very happy. So definitely the jackfruit tree was still there. So it is true. As a boy, the visitor used to swing on the turnstile. Yes, he used to swing on it. He became dizzy. So it is also true. The visitor had sold the house. Absolutely. He has sold the house. Because after the death of his grandmother, they have sold the house and they have gone. So that is also true. A girl came out of the house. Yes, she has come out of the house. So that is also true. So she has come out of the house through the wall, right? So that is also true. Question number 6. The visitor's father, grandfather, used to sit on the stone bench. Is it true? No, absolutely it is false. Because the visitor's grandmother only had the habit of sitting on the stone bench. So it is false. Okay, question number 7. The visitor was able to remember the music of a piano. Yes, absolutely. He was able to listen to the music of the piano, the chiming of the clock, the starting, the cranking sound of the, what is the car, etc., etc. So it is absolutely true. Okay, next one. The visitor was able to climb the jackfruit. Look at the title, it is false. I can't climb the climb trees anymore. The title itself. So it is false, my dear children. The visitor was not able to climb. Okay, the visitor was able to climb the jackfruit tree. It's false. Yes, Madhini. The purpose of the visit of the narrator was to buy his ancestral house back. Was he there to buy his ancestral house? Absolutely not. So it is false. The visitor climbed over the wall easily. Did he climb it very easily? No, not at all. So it is false. Pardon, my dear children. Let me tell the answers. Question number 1, true. Question number 2, true. Question number 3, true. Question number 4, true. Question number 5, true. Question number 6, false. Question number 7, true. Question number 8 is false. Question number 9 is false. And question number 10 is also false. Is that clear? It's okay. Y'all might have committed some mistake. Don't worry. I hope y'all would have understood it. So there's not going to be any worries to be there. Okay. Right. Let's move on to the next exercise. 8 out of 10. I don't want your marking. Don't worry. It's not at all an issue. Now y'all would have understood it, I guess. Don't worry. Okay. Come to the B part. Now leave off. Leave off the true and true or false for God and heaven's sake. Now we'll move on to the next one. Okay, based on your understanding of the story, answer the following questions by choosing the correct answer. The first two is here. Complete it as early as possible. We'll move on to the next page for the rest of the questions. Okay, question number 1. The story, I Can't Climb Trees Anymore, highlights the importance of what? Old age, youth, adulthood, middle age. Old age, says Raja Rishika. Are they talking about old age here? Finally, at the end of the story, what did he recollect? He recollected all his youthfulness and he went back, right? So how come it become old age? It's youth. Option B, youth is the right answer. Check your answers, dear children. Listen to the story. If you're not able to understand, please read it. If still you all can't understand the story, just ask it to me. I will definitely tell it to you. Right? Question number two. The house which was visited by the man dash. Option A remained unchanged, was totally changed, was slightly repaired, was given a facelift. Remained unchanged. The house was untouched, no? Only a house was built outside the house. The house is totally unchanged. Option A is the right answer, dear children. Remained unchanged. Question number three. Let me zoom it for y'all. Okay. Question number three. Who said a blessing rests on the house where the shadow of a tree falls? Who said it? Grandmother, uncle, grandfather, the visitor. Yeah, you're absolutely right, my dear children. Very good, Yobharti. Grandmother. Option A, grandmother is the right answer. Option A, grandmother. Okay. Question number four. The visitor came back to the house because he dashed. Wanted to sell the jackfruit, see the jackfruit tree, was looking for his youth, wanted to look again at his old house, wanted to buy the house. Yeah, very good. Now you are getting it absolutely right, my dear children. The correct answer is option B. Was looking for his lost youth. Question number four, option B is the right answer. Was looking for his lost youth. All right, question number five. The visitor gifted the dash to the little girl. What did he give as a gift? Jocelyn, was it the old coins? My goodness, Jocelyn. Was it old coins? Absolutely not, my dear children. What did the young girl go on top and take and come back? What did the narrator give her? It was the iron cross, right? Option A, iron cross is the right answer, my dear children. I'm really shocked to see an answer like old coins. Old coins were absolutely hidden in the jackfruit tree. But what was taken out from there? It was the iron cross. That was provided as a gift. The visitor gifted the iron cross to the girl, little girl. Fine. Let us check the answers. Question number one, the answer is youth. Question number two, option A, remained unchanged. Question number three, option A, grandmother. Question number four, option B, was looking for his lost youth. And question number five, option A, iron cross. Is there any doubts, my dear children? Are there any doubts? Very good, Jayadu. Jaya Akshaya doesn't have any doubt. Very good. Any others with doubt? Please post in your doubts. We are here to clear it. Right. Okay. C. Answer the following questions will be shared to you via Google Classroom. So we'll move on to D. Match the words in column A with the meanings in column B. So we are going to see the synonym part here. So one has been done for us. So we are not going to draw any line. If you have a book, use a pencil and draw the line. If you don't have the book, you can just wait for the answers. Okay, now try it out. Question number two onwards, you're going to try getting the answers correctly. So I will ask y'all, at that then and there itself, you can tell me the answers. Is that clear, my dear children? First one, they have done it for us, pruning. Yeah, absolutely. Question number two, chiming hyphen, the correct answer. So yeah, give me the answer alone. You don't worry, dear children. When I ask you all the question, you'll give me the answer, okay? Pruning is trimming a plant, okay. What is the meaning of chiming, ma? Chiming. Chiming. Very good, Srinija. Very good, Rahini. Chiming is emitting a sound. Emitting a sound, okay? It's a sound. Emitting a sound is the right answer. Right? Let's move on to question number three. Drenched. What is the meaning of the word called drenched? Shaky. Oh my goodness. No. Yeah, plenty are streaming in with the right answer. The correct answer is soaked. S-O-A-K-E-D. Soaked. SOAKED. Soaked is the right answer. Let's move on to question number 4. Dizzy. D-I-Z-Z-Y. Dizzy. What's your right answer? Yeah, absolutely right, my dear children. You're getting it nearly correct. The correct answer is shaky. S-H-A-K-Y. Shaky. Shaky is the right answer. Question number 5. Prosperous. What is the meaning of the word prosperous? Jocelyn, justice. Very good. Race me. Is it a collection of precious things? Really, do you think like that? No, race me. The correct answer is flourishing. F-L-O-U-R-I-S-H-I-N-G. Flourishing. Please take a note of it. Prosperous is flourishing. F-L-O-U-R-I-S-H-I-N-G. Yes, you got it right, Yadu. I hope you all would have completed it. Yeah, question number 6. Sprightliness. What is the meaning of the word sprightliness? It's very simple. We have seen it in the glossary part also. Yeah, yellow, fine. Very good. My voice is breaking only for Rajarishika, I think so. Check for your internet, Rajarishika. Lively is the correct answer. L-I-V-E-L-Y. Lively. Lively is the correct answer. Okay. Question number 7. Treasure. What is the meaning of the word treasure? Yes, Gopika. Absolutely right. Srinija, Jocelyn. Very good. Very good, Yuva Bharati. Very good, Yadu. Jaya, Rajarishika, very good. Very good, Rida. So the correct answer is a collection of precious things. A collection of precious things. Okay. Last one, rusty. What is the meaning of rusty? The word rusty. Yeah, your answer is correct. The correct answer is ancient. Ancient. Okay. Ancient. A-N-C-I-E-N-T. Ancient is the right answer. Okay, dear children, let me just tell you all the answers once again. Question number 1, trimming a plant. The correct answer is trimming a plant. Question number 2 is emit a sound. It's opposite question number 5, right? Emit a sound. Question number 3, drenched, soaked. It is straight to question number 1, okay? Soaked, S-O-A-K-E-D, soaked. Question number 4, shaky. The answer is shaky. It's opposite to question number 2. Question number 5, prosperous. The answer is flourishing. It is in front of question number 3. Question number 6, sprightliness. The answer is lively. It is straight to question number 4. Rajarishika, it is only for you. So please adjust yourself and sit down, ma. Question number 7 is pressure. The correct answer is a collection of precious things. It is opposite to question number 8. And question number 8, rusty. Rusty. Rusty, the answer is ancient. It is in front of question number 7. I hope you all would have understood the answers. Is there any doubt still, ma? Do you all have any doubt? Okay, fine. Very good. Let's move on to the next exercise. Read the shortened forms of the words and write the full form for the remaining words and complete the table given below. See, what we are going to do is these are known as contractions. Contraction means shortening a word. Say, for example, W-O-N hyphen T will be known as won't. What is the full form of it? Will not. I'd. When it comes as I'd, we use it as I had or I would. We will not use it as I did. Okay. I'll means I will. So like that, we are going to identify and write the words for the below contractions which are given here. Okay. U hyphen D. You would. So it will be pronounced as you would. Very good, Gopika. It will be written as you would. Please do write it, my dear children. No, Rahini, only you would will come. You can't write it as you had, right? You had means you have to write it fully only. We can't shrink it. You would is the right answer. Okay, now tell me the answer for the second one, Mahadev. Very good, Netra. Beautiful. Very good, Jaya, Akshaya, Resni. Very good, Rahini. Very good, Madhini. Very good, Rida. Yuvabharati. Very good, ma. Spot on. Siona has given all the answers. Very good. Niranchana, very good. They have. The correct answer is they have. Okay. Now tell me the contraction, the expansion of the word heed. He would. Yes, he would. W-O-U-L-D. He would is the right answer. Very good. Keep it up, my dear children. Very good. Very good, all. Question number four. He's. Question number four, he's. Can you give me the answer for he's? Yes, my dear children. He is. I-S-S. He is. Not he was, Ram Harish. Definitely you can't call it as he was, right? He is means he is. He is brilliant, which means he is brilliant. We can't say he was brilliant, right? Okay. Question number five, wasn't. Can you give me the expanded form of wasn't? Very good, Netra and Madhini. Very good, Resni. Very good, Jocelyn. Very good, Rida. Very good, Yadu again. Very good, Kavya. Very good, Yuvabharati. Was not is the correct answer. Was not. Okay, next one is isn't. What is the expansion of isn't? Very good, Madhini and Jocelyn. Very good, Resni. Very good, Srinija. Good, Kavya, Ram Harish. Gopika and Rajarishika, very good. Is not is the correct answer. Isn't means is not. Is not is the right answer. Okay. Next one, doesn't. Very simple. We use this word often. Doesn't. Yeah, very good. Ashwin. Very good. Very good, my dear children. Does not is the correct answer. Very good, Tarika. Keep it up. Does not. Does not is the right answer. Very good, Obia. Missing a lot of Obia's comments these days. Very good, Ashwin. Very good. Does not is the right answer. Arsir Arfan. Very good. Next one is aren't. What is the meaning of the word? Expansion of the word aren't. Very good, Niranchana Devi. Very good, Kartika. Very good, Kartika. Missing your comments these days. Somebody says it as would not. My goodness, there is no would at all, no. How could you tell it as would not, ma? Asir Arfan. Aren't is are not, right? R plus not, are not. A-R-E plus N-O-T, are not. Okay, next one. Wouldn't, very simple. Wouldn't. Aditya Darshan, very good. Ram Harish, very good. Rajarishika, Srinija, Siddha, very good. Very good, Yuvabharati. Would not is the correct answer. Very good, Netra and Ashwin. Would not is the right answer. I hope you are picking it up absolutely correct. Congratulations to everybody, my dear children. Okay, can't. The meaning of the word can't. Can't is what? Can't is cannot. Cannot is the right answer, my dear children. Cannot is the right word. Very good. I hope you all are able to understand the contractions. Okay, fine. We'll stop here. I hope you all have understood it fine. Thank you very much. Have a great day, my dear children. It was a very lively class. Thank you all.